हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज पवन एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल टेक्निकल नॉलेज। आई एम अ बिजनेस इंटेलिजेंस एंड डेटा वेयरहाउसिंग ट्रेनर एंड आई ट्रेन कॉर्पोरेट एम्प्लॉइज, फ्रेशर्स, स्टूडेंट्स ऑन इन्फोमेटिका, पावर सेंटर, टेरा डेटा, टैबल्यू एंड ओरेकल। आई होप इन दिस कोविड पेंडेमिक यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड यू ऑल आर स्टेइंग एट होम। इन दिस लॉकडाउन सिचुएशन लेट्स लर्न समथिंग न्यू। सो वॉट आर वी गोइंग टू लर्न टूडे? We are going to learn today Tableau basics and Tableau filter. So in this today's video, we are going to cover that what is Tableau and why we should learn Tableau and what are the Tableau basic filters. So let me start with Tableau basics, that what is Tableau. So basically, if you want to do analysis on your data and if you want to create some visualization, some chart on the basis of your source data, then this work can be done in Tableau. But the same work can also be done in the Excel file. So let me open my Excel file and let me show you that how you can do that data visualization work in your Excel file, and then later on we can see that in Tableau how easy it is comparatively to the Excel file. So this is my Excel file where my source data is kept. The Excel file name is Global Superstore 2016. Let me zoom in a bit. So what are the data we have in our Excel file? We have row ID, order ID, order date, ship date, and along with that we have couple of more columns: city, state, country, region, and the numeric column which we have on which we are going to perform our mathematical calculation, that is sales, discount, profit. So this is a basic global superstore data where some order IDs and data related to order is kept. So now if I want to create some data visualization onto this data, what we have to do is we have to go to this insert tab, we have to click on pivot table, click on OK, and some pivot table has been created. It's a blank pivot table. So what are the rows or what are the column which we are going to take into a pivot table? Let's suppose sales we want to keep into values. We are going to take category into rows, and along with the category we also want to take subcategory into rows. So if you see, a pivot table has been created. Now we have three categories: furniture, office supplies, and technology. Let me zoom in a bit. And along with these categories, we have subcategories in the furniture, bookcase, chair, furnishing, and tables. And all the sales value has been summed up. Now, if you want to create a data visualization or a chart on the basis of this pivot table, what we are going to do, we're going to click on insert, go to chart, and create a 3D chart. So in this way, you can create a data visualization. And if you want to filter out on your data, you have to click on this, click on furniture, and you are going to look the data on the basis of furniture category only. So this is a quite tedious way, or this is quite a long way, and you cannot get much information from this chart. So this is a basic Excel kind of work. So let me open my Tableau software. So let me start from the very beginning, that how you can connect your Excel file to this Tableau, and then how you can create your data visualization. Let me open my Tableau software. So this is the user interface of Tableau software. First window, you just have to click on this Microsoft Excel, and you have to click on that Global Superstore 2016 data, and you have to import your file. Now in that file we have three tabs. So the first tab we have to drag and drop here, and now at the bottom you can see that a sheet 1 has been appeared up. You just have to click on this sheet 1 and you have to create your data visualization here. So I hope all the columns you are able to see at the left side. So Tableau is way smarter that all the columns which are available in your Excel file, it has segregated your column into dimensions and measures. So what are the dimensions? Dimensions are the categorical variable like the textual values or the geographical values like city, country, or any other textual values like customer ID, customer name, or any other date field like order date or shipping date. So all these values are segregated into dimensions, and all the other numerical values are segregated into measures. What are the measures? Measures are the numerical number on which you have to perform your mathematical calculations. So Tableau is way smarter. In Excel, every column or every field is together, but in Tableau, all the columns or all the fields are segregated into dimensions and measures. So this is the basic user interface of Tableau worksheet. Now what we have to do is we have to take category into rows, subcategory into rows, and we have to take sales into column. And you can see that within less than 5 seconds, your graph or your bar chart has been created. You can also format it. Just click here so that you can get this view. If you want to sort it, you just click here. The data has been sorted. If you want to know the sales figure also, you just have to click on this T button and the sales figure has come up against you. So within less than 5 seconds, you can create your visualization and you can get your data visualization very easy manner. Okay, so not only this, you can create some bar chart onto this Tableau. There are a lot of features and a lot of functionalities are available in Tableau. You can learn and you can make your own pie chart, graph chart, you can make your own dashboards, you can make own your storylines. You can perform many more things on the basis of business requirement, how you are going to create your visualization. So this is the basic Tableau part, that on the Excel file, if you want to create your data visualization or you want to create a dashboard, it takes a lot of time. But as far as Tableau is concerned, in the Tableau, you can do your work at the very minimum time. And this is not only the feature, there are plenty of features are available that you can learn in Tableau and you can enhance your skills. So this is just an information. If you want to take up the entire course on Tableau, all the details are given in the description box, the contact details and the website link. So all the details are given at the description box. So if you want to take up the complete course, kindly go to description box and check out the details. So this is the Tableau basic part. The second part which we are going to cover up in this today's video is Tableau filters. So what are the Tableau filters? Let's suppose if you want to filter out some data on the basis of business requirement, you can filter out your data as well. So if you want to filter out your data on the basis of subcategory, so what you have to do is you just have to drag that column and put it into filters. A window will appear. So what you have to do is you just have to click on apply and OK. See, nothing has been filtered out because we have checked each and everything. Now if you want to edit your filter, just click on this subcategory and click on edit filter. Now if you want to edit your data on the basis of any subcategory, you just have to uncheck that and you have to click apply and you have to click OK. And see, your data has been filtered out the moment you have unchecked those subcategories into the filter. But this is also a kind of tedious way. I want a shortcut way so that I can filter out my data. You just have to click here and click on show filters. And the moment you click on the show filters, a filter legend has been created. So from here only, on your fingertips, you can filter out your data like anything. If you want all the values, just click on all and everything will be available. Okay, so in the filter also, there are plenty of options available. Just click here and click on edit options and click on select all. So this is the first general tab which we have covered up if you want to edit your data or if you want to filter out your data. The second tab in the filter shelf or in the filter we have is wildcard. So let's suppose I want to filter out my data on the basis of any alphabet. I only want to see the category which starts with A. So I'll click on this start with button and then press capital A. Capital A, I'm pressing capital A because it's a case sensitive. Or if I press small a, the filter will not be applied. So I have to give a capital A. Click on apply and click on OK. So the subcategory which is starting from the capital A only, you can see only those subcategory onto my bar chart. Now again click on this edit filter. So this is your wildcard. Similarly, you can also apply a filter end with, let's suppose I only want the data which is ending with S, or if I only want to see the subcategories which is ending with S. So just type S here, click on apply and click on OK. So these all are the values which, or these all are the subcategories which is ending with S. Again, go to the edit filter tab. So this was your general tab where you can filter out your data. This was your wildcard tab where you can filter out your data on the basis of any alphabetical filter. Now the third tab which we have is condition tab. What is that condition tab? Let's suppose I want to filter out my data on the basis of sales or on the basis of sum of sales. So I have a specific condition that the sum of sales should be greater than 10 lakh. And if I click on apply and if I click on OK, so I only will be able to see the subcategories whose sales is more than 10 lakhs. So in that way, if you have any condition, you can apply these conditions and you can filter out your data. So let me click on edit filter once again. So this is your condition tab which we have seen right now. Let me click on none. And this is the last tab in the filter itself, which is known as top tab. So let's suppose, what is my business requirement? In this, my business requirement is I want to top 5 values on the basis of sum of sales. So those categories who is giving me top 5 sales, I only want to see those subcategories. So what I'll do is I'll click on by field, and here instead of 10, I'll give top 5 on the basis of sum of sales, and click on apply and click on OK. So these are the top 5 sales which I'm getting. So on the basis of, or with the help of top tab in the filter, I can get the data on the basis of top. Just let me click here to sort the data. Now what is my next requirement? My next requirement is I want to filter out my data on the basis of bottom 5. So let me click here, click on edit filter. Let me go to the top tab, and instead of top, from the drop down list, I'll select bottom. So I will get my data on the basis of bottom 5 and on the basis of sum of sales. So those sum of sales who belongs to bottom 5, I'll only be able to see those bottom 5 values. Now click on apply and click on OK. So these are the bottom 5 sales which I'm getting from my filter. So this is the filter option which we have in Tableau. On the basis of this filter conditions, you can filter out your data according to your business condition. Let me give you one more shortcut way with the help of, you can apply this filter in a very quick way. Just remove it from the filter. I want to filter out my data on the basis of subcategory. So what you need to do is just click on this subcategory and click on show filter. So that subcategory will automatically come into filter, and a filter or an interactive filter will also be created. This is the interactive filter on the basis of which you can filter out your data on your fingertips. So I hope you'll be able to understand this video, that what is Tableau and how you can create your data visualization into Tableau in a very short span of time, and you can filter out your data with so many filter options. So that's all for this video. I hope you have enjoyed this video. So if you like this video, kindly subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. In future also, we are going to upload this kind of informative video related to Informatica, Teradata, Tableau, Unix and Oracle. So kindly subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. So we are a training organization called SkillUpRight. So if you want to learn the entire course on Tableau, the website link, the contact number, the email ID and link to download the complete course content has been given in the description box. So if you are interested to taking up the complete course, the link to download the course content has been given. Kindly download the course content and kindly contact onto the given number if you want to take up the complete course. It is just a small basic part of Tableau. There are a lot of plenty of features and functionalities are to be learned in Tableau, and we are providing the complete training with a very minimum cost. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching.